Hey guys, in this video I will be showing you some really useful abilities that you'll want to unlock as soon as possible in RuneScape 3. RS3 has so many different abilities that can be unlocked through various ways, so much so that it can get a bit confusing for players to know which abilities to get and when, and also their various uses. So in this guide I'll be explaining some of the best abilities to unlock based on their current value. So the first ability or set of abilities in this case are the tendril abilities. So specifically we're talking about the blood, shadow, and smoke tendril abilities. These abilities are obtained as a reward from the dig site quest, and they are useful threshold abilities for each combat style. So since they are a quest reward, they are free to unlock, meaning every player should unlock these really easily, which is why they are first on the list, just because there isn't actually any value on them, but they are some really useful abilities to have. All three abilities are powerful threshold abilities that will deal ability damage over time, meaning they are sort of like a bleed. However, they will also cause you to take some damage as well, which is why they are sometimes a risky ability to use. But besides that, they are a really powerful ability and will deal a lot of damage, and they should be put into a lot of your ability rotations. Next, we have the ability Tuska's Wrath. This is a basic constitution ability that can be unlocked for 4,000 of the currency from the Anima Islands Distraction and Diversion. This is a really useful ability, especially when training Slayer. So basically, it is a basic ability, as I mentioned, and if you are on a Slayer task, it will deal 10,000% of your Slayer level as damage to your active Slayer target, and then it will cool down for 2 full minutes. So this is a really useful ability on Slayer tasks. It will be your strongest ability to use whenever you are on a Slayer task. Now, if you aren't on a Slayer task, you will deal 30 to 110% ability damage, which also is a pretty decent basic ability that you can use as well, but it is mostly used for those Slayer tasks. So if you are someone who does like training Slayer or is looking to train it up, this is an ability that you will want to get since it is extremely helpful to have. This next ability is also another pretty easy ability to get, and a lot of you guys probably already have it. It is the Devotion ability. So this is a defensive ability, and when activated, Protection Prayers and Deflect Curses reduce the damage of the styles that they defend against by 100%, and it does last 9.6 seconds. Then also, if you do kill an enemy while this is activated, it will increase the duration by 4.8 seconds to a maximum of 19.2. So this is a really useful ability to use in a lot of different situations, especially boss fights. The ability also is pretty easy to obtain, so you can obtain it multiple different ways. A lot like Tuska's Wrath, you can obtain it from the Anima Islands D&D. It does cost 3,500 reward currency there. However, another way to obtain this is by getting it as a rare drop from General Grardor or Crayara. This is the recommended way to get it since these bosses are fairly easy to kill. And then also you don't have to spend all that time grinding for the reward currency for the Anima Islands. As this ability is fairly easy to obtain, a lot of you guys probably do have it, but if you don't already have it, make sure you do get this ability since it is one of the most essential abilities to have. Bladed Dive is another really useful ability to obtain for a lot of different reasons. So this ability is a basic ability, and it is required to have dual-wield melee weapons equipped to use it. But what it does, it allows you to dash forward a lot like Surge, but if you are actively attacking a target, you will dash forward and deal 25 to 125% ability damage. So this makes it a really good ability just for movement and more mobility, and also it does deal a little bit of damage as well. Another key feature about the ability is that it does deal damage to 9 targets adjacent to its destination. So this makes it a pretty good AoE ability as well. It is a really useful just melee ability in general to have. So this ability does have a lot of different uses. One use is certain boss fights, especially Raksha, where it does have the Shadow Anima pools. Bladed Dive is a really useful ability for dashing around to those pools and killing them really effectively using the adjacent or AoE ability damage. So it is useful for certain aspects of PVM like that, but it also is just useful for getting around quickly. You can use Surge, Double Surge, and then you can also use Bladed Dive as another ability to get around even faster. This is really helpful for things like Big Game Hunter, where mobility is really important, and it also is helpful for clue scrolls or just anything where you are running around a lot. The ability is obtained through the Shattered Worlds minigame. It does cost 63 million Shattered Anima, so it does take a few hours to get at least, but it is definitely worth it. Now, the next two abilities are Corruption Shot and Corruption Blast. They are identical abilities for ranged and magic. What these abilities do, they're sort of like a bleed ability. They do 33% to 100% ability damage every 1.2 seconds over 6 seconds, so it does last 5 game ticks. And every 1.2 seconds, the damage will spread to nearby enemies as well, so it does have a sort of a bit of an AoE effect as well. This ability is a really great ability to add on to the basic abilities for both ranged and magic. It is one that you are going to want to purchase, and a lot like the previous abilities, you do actually have to purchase this one, or else you can get it through completing raids, but you will get it by using a MazCap ability codex. These are worth 40 million each on the Grand Exchange. And you can only pick one ability every time you use it. So to get both abilities, it will cost a total of 80 mil. So it is quite expensive to get them, but they are some really useful basic abilities for both the combat styles. Next, we have the two alternate abilities, Death Swiftness and Sunshine. And these are probably the most important abilities that you guys should obtain. They are free, which is why I put them at this spot on the list. So you do get them as a reward for completing the World Wakes quest. And these abilities, as I mentioned, are extremely useful. So they're basically the main abilities that you are going to be using for both combat styles. Death Swiftness, it basically creates a sort of shroud around yourself, and it will boost your range damage by 50% when you are inside it. It'll also deal 10 to 20% ability damage to targets around it, and it does last 30 seconds. So you will want to use this every time you reach 100% adrenaline, or at least in most PVM situations you will want to use it. Because then when you use it, you'll get 50% increased damage, so when you use your threshold abilities, they will deal even more damage. Sunshine is identical to Death Swiftness, however it is for magic. So basically the same thing, you want to use it, and then you can use your threshold abilities to increase your damage. You can also increase the duration of these two abilities to 37.8 seconds if you do use the Planted Feet perk. So this is also another combination which will make these abilities even more powerful. But basically, these abilities, they are going to be ones that you want to strive for on your account, since they are extremely important abilities to have, and your ability rotations will basically revolve around both of these two abilities. Now, moving on to our next ability, it is the Limitless ability. This is a basic ability, and it is the most expensive ability that I have on this list. It does cost 2,000 Vital Sparks to make this ability, which basically costs around 370 to 400 mil right now. So it is a really expensive ability to have, and it's one that you might not get if you are a newer player. But it is extremely important, and it will boost your DPS by quite a bit. So as you can see in this clip, I'm actually showing you guys how I would use this. So once you get that 100% adrenaline, like I said, you want to use Death Swiftness. But then when you use the Limitless ability, it allows you to use threshold abilities when you are below 50% adrenaline. So it is super helpful to use when you do have a Death Swiftness or a Sunshine active, That's because then you can use your threshold abilities without reaching that 50% adrenaline. The ability only lasts 6 seconds, and it can only be used when you are below 60% adrenaline. So it is a really useful ability to use as soon as you use that ultimate ability. So on screen I have a few examples of some ability rotations you would want to use when you are using the limitless ability. So you can see that you will want to build up some adrenaline after you use that ultimate ability. That's because you will still have to spend some adrenaline when using the threshold abilities. So the only difference when using Limitless is you don't have to have the 50% adrenaline requirement. The threshold abilities will instead only require the 15% adrenaline, which they actually do consume. So when you do use these ultimate abilities, Death Swiftness and Sunshine, you'll then want to use some basic abilities as well as possibly an adrenaline potion. That way you will gain some more adrenaline, and then you can use 15% adrenaline on each of your threshold abilities after that. Now, these next few abilities that I am going to be talking about, they are really expensive, so they are sort of an honorable mention in this video. But I'm talking about Greater Ricochet and Greater Chain. So Greater Ricochet costs around 400 to 500 mil right now, and then the Greater Chain ability costs around 200 mil right now. So they are really expensive abilities, but they are extremely useful, especially Greater Ricochet if you are using ranged. So what these abilities do, Greater Ricochet, to start off with, it is a enhancement of the Ricochet ability. So the difference between Greater Ricochet and Ricochet is that if the extra arrows cannot find an additional target, the primary target will be hit for an additional 10 to 50% ability damage for each Ricochet shot that cannot find this extra target. So regularly there are a total of 2 extra arrows, meaning that this ability will deal 40% to 200% ability damage. And this is just a basic ability. Now, if you do add the chroming perk onto this, it will allow you to reach up to 6 Ricochet arrows, meaning that you can deal a minimum of 80% ability damage and a maximum of 400%. And this is only for a basic ability. So if you are someone who does use ranged a lot, and you especially kill bosses using ranged, Greater Ricochet is an excellent ability to invest in. Although it does cost 400 to 500 mil, it is an ability that you really do need to look at unlocking. Now, the Greater Chain is another ability that can be purchased or obtained through Raksha. Now, this ability is really useful for magic. It's a bit different from Greater Ricochet. Greater Ricochet mostly focuses on a single target or dealing damage to a single target, whereas Greater Chain adds a really nice AoE ability to it. So basically, the difference between Greater Chain and the regular chain ability is that the next ability on the primary target is also cast on the additional targets with a 50% damage reduction. As I mentioned, normally you will hit 2 extra targets with this, but with the chroming perk, you will hit a maximum of 6 extra targets. So this is a really useful ability to add some AoE ability damage with magic, and it really does help if you are using magic while doing Slayer or things with a lot of different mobs. Now, lastly, I wanted to talk about the 3 abilities that you get from Elite Dungeon 1. Greater Flurry, Greater Fury, and Greater Barge. So all 3 of these abilities are upgraded versions of regular melee abilities, and they do have some pretty good uses to them. Greater Flurry is probably the worst of these 3 abilities, but it still does have some uses. So basically what it does, it is the same as Flurry when you are dealing with multiple different targets. However, for each hit, it will reduce the cooldown of Berserk by 1.2 seconds. And then also, when you are attacking a single target, the damage per hit is increased from 94% to 257%, which allows you to deal a maximum of 628% total ability damage. The ability costs around 75 mil and is fairly useful as a nice upgrade to the Flurry ability. Now, the Greater Fury ability is a bit different. This is a nice upgrade to the Fury ability. It changes it from a channeled ability to a non-channeled ability, which is really nice. So Greater Fury deals a single hit of up to 157 ability damage instead of the three smaller hits that Fury does. And then also it does boost the critical chance by 10% for your next ability. And you will gain 100% critical chance on your next ability if the Greater Fury critical strikes. So it is a really useful ability to use before you use a more powerful ability. So for example, if you do use an ability like Berserk, which doubles your damage, you can then regain some adrenaline and then use Greater Fury before using one of your strongest threshold abilities like Hurricane. Now, lastly, we have the Greater Barge ability. This ability costs around 300 mil, so it is quite a bit more expensive than the 75 mil for Greater Flurry and the 200 mil for Greater Fury. But Greater Barge is another really useful ability. It's a really nice upgrade to the Barge ability and actually changes it to somewhat of a bleed ability. So the Greater Barge ability is pretty interesting and actually gains damage for every 0.6 seconds since your last attack, up to a maximum of 6 seconds. So if you do this, you will deal an extra 100% damage upon use of this ability. And then also, if you waited at least 4.8 seconds before using this ability, then you will actually gain a little bit of a buff on your next attack. So basically, it will allow you to combo off of this ability using a channeled ability like Fury, Assault, Flurry, Greater Flurry, Destroy, or Frenzy. So if one of these abilities is used within 6 seconds of casting Greater Barge, then its damage will deal damage over time as opposed to being a regular channeled ability. So this is a really useful ability when you are using channeled abilities, because channeled abilities are historically a lot worse. So changing this to a damaged over time ability does help a lot. So Greater Barge is a really useful ability if you are using melee, and it's one that you guys should invest in if melee is one of your main combat styles. So anyway guys, those are all of the abilities that you really need to unlock in RuneScape 3. Of course, you will want to prioritize as to which ones you'll want to unlock first. Of course, a lot of these abilities are free to unlock as they are rewards from quests, but the abilities that you will need to purchase, you will want to prioritize based on what combat style you use the most. Limitless, however, is a really useful ability for every combat style, so that's why it should be one of the top priorities for you guys if you are looking to improve your DPS. Anyway guys, that is all I have for you in this video. I really hope you did enjoy this video and found it helpful. And if you did, make sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe for more RuneScape 3 content. And I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.